We begin with breaking news this noon. Schools threats across the Bay State. Police say more than a dozen schools are involved right now. Good afternoon. I'm Chris McKinnon.
And I'm Catherine Hauser. Thank you for being here with us. We have a look at the confirmed threats right now from Tewksbury all the way down to Plymouth. Susie Steimel is live for us in Arlington, where police have just spoken about a threat there as well. Susie.
That's right, Catherine. Police say they do believe that all of these threats are connected. And as we know, often threats to schools are false. But there takes a level of severity for police to shut down a school. Here, the call came in that a backpack would explode and that any other remaining students would be shot. The threats just kept coming. By 11 a.m., there were 11 separate threats to schools across the Commonwealth. In Arlington, more than 1,300 students had to be evacuated. Chief Fred Ryan recognizes how frustrating these incidents are for teachers, parents, and students, but reiterates just how paramount safety is.
We have to make split-second decisions based on the threat, not knowing that it's going on throughout the Commonwealth.
Not only are these threats frustrating, but they're costly. For police, it's exorbitant resources being spent. For students, it's an emotional cost.
It's scary. It's a big deal. Definitely.
But yeah, it is kind of like scary knowing this happened to us, and then on Friday the same thing happened to AC. It's kind of like, I don't know, just kind of wondering like what the whole thing is like.
To whoever did this, Chief Ryan says he can't wait to meet you.
Those that are responsible for these threats are committing serious felonies, disrupting learning in communities throughout this Commonwealth. And I have a high degree of confidence they'll be identified and prosecuted for the felonies that they're committing. This is extremely disruptive to our communities.
Police will continue to investigate on scene today until they determine that this threat is not viable. As you just heard the chief say, he thinks they'll be able to make an arrest in this case. We're live in Arlington. Susie Steimel, WBZ News.